Hillary Clinton, the amazing feminist who accepts hundreds of millions of dollars from countries that oppress women, calls women bimbos, and intimidates Bill Clinton's rape victims, played the vagina card once again during the debates in an effort to smear Trump as a woman hater.
And one of the worst things he said was about a woman in a beauty contest. Donald, she has a name.
Where did you find
her? Her name
Where
is Alicia Machado.
Where did you find
And
it?
She has become a U.S. citizen, and you can bet she's going to vote this November.
Okay, good.
So who is Alicia Machado, this amazing role model for young women who's standing up against a torrent of misogynistic abuse? She's accused of driving the getaway car for a murder attempt. She threatened to kill a judge. She had an illegitimate child with a Mexican drug lord. She also had sex on reality TV while being engaged to someone else. What a fantastic feminist role model for young women. This is Hillary's campaign poster child.
He can say whatever he wants to say. I don't care. You know, I have my past. Of course, everybody has. Everybody have a past.
Yeah, not everybody's past includes being accused of acting as an accomplice in an attempted murder and threatening to kill a judge. That's kind of out of the ordinary, Alicia. But Trump is the villain of the piece for allegedly fat-shaming her, even though CNN did exactly the same thing. He's bad for being judgmental of beauty in a beauty pageant that he owned. Watch the video where Trump supposedly fat-shames her. He's being incredibly complimentary. In fact, it's Trump who's defending her against others who were pressuring her over her weight.
I felt that Alicia was one of the most beautiful women I'd ever seen. It was incredible. And all of the folks that were here agreed with that. Alicia is like me and like a lot of other people. I love to eat. We all love to eat. Not all of us. Some of you are lucky. But we eat. We like to eat. And she had tremendous pressure put on her with the win and everything else. Plus, she was going from country to country, all foreign places. And there was a huge amount of pressure. When she won the contest, I had never seen anybody more beautiful. And she's totally beautiful now. You know, you have a lot of people that have problems with weight, eating disorders, whatever you want to call it. A lot of people. I mean, I'm looking at a lot of you reporters, and I can't believe how many showed up. But a lot of you folks have weight problems, I hate to tell you. But doesn't it?
Machado also brazenly lied when she said that Trump's mean comments led to her eating disorder. She had that disorder before she even entered Miss Universe.
You said as a result of what he said to you, you developed an eating disorder, bulimia, and anorexia. But you had said publicly at the time that you suffered from both of those eating disorders prior to the Miss Universe contest and really, you know, had come into...
No, never prior than Miss Universe pageant. I never...
Well, this is from
any problem before the Miss Universe.
Well, this is from Washington Post.
Sorry. That happened after.
Let me just tell you what I'm referring to and then you respond. The Washington Post from May 16th, 1997 reported this quote from you. I was anorexic and bulimic, but almost all of us are. When I was preparing for Miss Universe, it was an obsession for me to not gain weight. By the time I won, I was actually recovering. But the year leading to it, I didn't eat at all, and whatever I ate, I threw up. I weighed 116 pounds when I won. I was skeletal. So it sounds like, without diminishing anything that you went through after Trump, it does sound like you had an eating disorder prior to his comments and prior to winning.
So Trump drew attention to this sex tape where Machado romps on screen while being engaged to someone else. And Hillary accused him of being a conspiracy theorist, claiming that Machado never appeared in a sex tape. Even though she clearly did appear in a sex tape. But the New York Times says its fact checkers found no evidence of a sex tape. So she's having sex on tape, and that's not a sex tape. Oh, but that was just a risque scene, the Times reported. Listen to what Machado was recorded on tape saying during the encounter. Oh, your dick, my love, what a tasty dick. Your dick is divine. Does that sound risque to you? Or does it sound like what you'd hear on a sex tape? The New York Times is flagrantly lying to its readers, and Trump has been vindicated yet again. Alicia Machado clearly appeared in a sex tape. That's a fact. You had grimy sex on national television yet you accuse Trump of objectifying you. Yeah, Alicia, I think you did a pretty good job of objectifying yourself. Hillary's decisions led to 4 dead Americans, a ruined country, the displacement of millions of people, and the international migrant crisis. And yet Trump's the terrible person for allegedly calling a woman fat 20 years ago. And this is what the media wants to talk about. Hillary vowed to crucify women who were victims of her sexual predator husband. She laughed about defending a child rapist who molested a 12-year-old girl. She takes mountains of cash from Saudi Arabia, a country that treats women like cattle. She intimidates vulnerable female rape victims. But it's Trump who hates women because he called Rosie O'Donnell fat and encouraged Miss Universe to lose weight while representing a beauty pageant that he owned. Really? Women don't fear for their life because of Donald Trump. They do fear for their life because of the Clintons. Until the media reports on Hillary intimidating Bill's rape victims, they can shut the hell up about Trump's treatment of women. Alicia Mercado is a terrible role model for young women, and yes, she appeared in a sex tape. And now all this has come to light, it's blown up in Hillary's stupid face. Which is why the New York Times and the rest of the corrupt establishment media is having to lie about it to run defense for her.
Hillary. For some reason, your extremely underdeveloped frontal lobe has foolishly led you to believe that it would be a brilliant idea to run in the 2016 presidential campaign. As a result, true-blooded American patriots such as myself, the ones who are actually still loyal to this country, have had to endure that painful scratching noise that you like to call intelligence spew from your mouth like typical Clinton diarrhea. As agonizing as this has been to watch, what is more disconcerting to me is that you are capable of standing up in front of the world to proclaim that you possess not only the capabilities, but also the credentials to run this beloved country. And thinking that you would do anything but drive the rest of what we have left to our name straight into the seventh circle of hell. I must say, your ability to keep a straight face throughout this entire process is almost impressive. Unfortunately for you, there are still many of us who see through your carefully sculpted mask and straight into the eyes of one of the biggest traitors this country has ever taken under her wing. For those of you who are ignorant enough to follow blindly behind the Clinton circus of bona fide bitch bags, let me just break this down stupid style so that you can keep up. Gestapo, Silly Billy's Dirty Secret Scandal, stealing from the White House, Filegate, Hillary's Deputy Chief of Staff, Huma Abedin, Vince Foster, Emailgate, Whitewater, when Hillary said she landed under sniper fire in Bosnia. The Clinton body count, Benghazi, Chinagate, Travelgate, Watergate, drug dealer donor scandal, Ponzi scheme and political favor scandal, and you, Hillary, the biggest scandal of them all. And you think that you have the credentials with this background to run my country? In 1974, you were fired from your job by your supervisor, Jerry Seifman, who said, and I quote, "She was an unethical and dishonest lawyer. She conspired to violate the Constitution, the rules of the House, the rules of the committee, and the rules of confidentiality." Does that really sound like an individual who is fit to lead this country? I cannot determine what is more alarming to me. A group of Islamic extremists who brutally execute thousands of men, women, and children in front of the world, or a presidential candidate that has a record of illegal activity, which she should have been incarcerated for, with her own hidden agenda to destroy what's left of these United States and the connections and friendships to do so. You have, on a number of occasions proven to the wolves that roam this land that you are, by very definition, a traitor to not only the United States of America, but a traitor to your own integrity. You stand on the forefront of the greatest election since our independence and stumble over our Constitution while catching your balance on our liberties. Countless times you have proven yourself a disgrace to those who do not sit idly by and listen to your proverbial and narcissistic diatribe that you preach to the weak-minded. You have literally turned your back on the men and women who have bled for the power that you abuse, men and women who have selflessly died in war to protect the freedoms of our countrymen, men and women who have left their families and set aside their differences and laid down their lives so that you can steal their liberties, laugh at their sacrifices, and mock their honor. And now you assume that you possess the bravery to lead my brothers and sisters into war? To command them with integrity on a battlefield seated with honor? You have spit in the face of the very foundation that you still have the privilege of standing on. You have unmasked the very image of what a coward looks like, and you have most certainly managed to mask the truth of your deceit so the blind cannot recognize you for what you really are, a waste of human existence. You are not fit to lead this country anywhere except straight back down the shitter that you crawled out of. You are a prisoner of your own evil, chained down by the shackles of your arrogance and strapped to the grenade of American justice that you just pulled the pin on. It is only a matter of time until the shrapnel blows up into your ass and out of that treacherous mouth that you used to deceive your way to the top. And the people of this great country will have front row seats to the execution of your career. And the men and women who have lost their lives at the hands of your deliberate negligence will no longer be dangling from your guilt-free conscience. My country will not fall to the hands of your corrupt administration. I need you to understand something, America. If you vote for Hillary, you will be handing over the last shred of integrity that this country has to a woman who willfully threw hers away many years ago. She is not the answer to America's problems. She is America's problem. Ladies, if you're voting for Clinton based solely on the fact that her vagina fits your incessant need for vagina power, do us all a favor. Go sit on your thumb, wiggle it around a little, and let me know if you find your brain up there. Until then, stay as far away from the polls as possible before you hurt yourselves. I'll end this with a quote from my father. Hillary, you are prevaricating, disingenuous, disrespectful, and egocentric bag of runny fecal matter. The only job you are fit for is a poster child for Soylent Green. If only your mother would have swallowed. End quote. Go fuck yourself.